here in Higley Town. Things all jump around, just like the Higley Town heroes. They all work together, making fun together. Come see the Higley Town heroes. You be Wayne, Twinkle, Kip, and Fran, all hop and pop around. Soon they'll learn about real heroes, who and why. With all the Higley Town heroes, let's all play together, save the day together. Come join the Higley Town heroes.
The Fran and the Moon.
Well, goodness gracious! Oh, what have we here? It looks like you two are about to become a perfectly proud pair of parents.
Hey, Fran, what you doing?
Howdy there, kids. I'm just visiting with my neighbors, the Robins. Once their chicks hatch, our cozy little tree sure will get a lot cozier.
I can't wait to hear them chirp, chirp, chirping. Hi, Mr. Kip's dad. Are you digging a hole to China?
No, Wayne. I'm digging a hole so I can plant a tree. I'm doing my part for Earth Day.
Earth Day? What's that?
Earth Day is a special day when we celebrate our special planet, Earth. And it's a reminder that we need to take care of all the living things on it.
By keeping the land and water and air clean, don't you know?
But why are you planting a tree, Dad? Is it because they're fun to climb?
That's one reason.
Is it because they make good homes for birds and squirrels?
That's another good reason.
Is it because they're pretty to look at?
I'm planting a tree for all those reasons, kids. Trees are good for the planet.
You sure do care an awful lot about the planet, Mr. Kip's dad.
I sure do, Twinkle. The Earth is our home. Earth is my planet, the place I call home, in the Milky Way galaxy. Of all of the planets up in the stars, Earth is the planet for me, the planet for me. Clean air, endless oceans, mountains to the sky. Painted rainbows rise in the air. Green plants, forest jungles, creatures great and small. And Earth is the blue ball that we all share.
Jupiter, Saturn, Venus, and Mars.
They don't have water or trees.
There isn't any air for anyone to breathe.
So Earth is the planet for me.
The planet for me. Clean air, endless oceans, mountains to the skies. Painted rainbows rise in the air. Green plants, forest jungles, creatures great and small. And Earth is the blue ball that we all share.
Earth is my planet, the place I call home.
The only home for you and me.
I'm gonna take care of my beautiful home.
'Cause Earth is a planet for me, the planet for me. The planet for me.
Oh, good giblet gravy. We just planted a tree.
Congratulations, kids. You helped our planet for Earth Day.
So what's next, Dad?
Next?
Yeah. What else can we do to help the planet? We want to do more.
Well, kids, if you really want to do more,
why don't you come and help us clean up Higley Park?
Okay, Aunt Melly and Uncle Zooter. Count us in. I never knew picking up candy wrappers was so much work or so sticky.
It's work, all righty.
But you kids should be proud because of all your hard work.
Higley Park is spotless now.
Yay!
Something the matter?
You be darling.
Well, I'm glad we helped you clean up Higley Park, but now we're all done. And I want to do more for Earth Day.
Well, there's always more.
You can do for Earth Day?
There is? Like what?
Like recycling cans and bottles. Something my diner's got plenty of. Hey, you kids want to give me a hand?
Last one there is a lopsided litter mug. More cans coming through.
You sure do have a lot of bottles and cans, Uncle Emo.
Yep, and I recycle each and every one of them. After I drop them off at the recycling center, they're melted down and used to make new bottles and cans. And because there's less trash, the earth is cleaner. There. All done. Thanks, kids. You've been a great help.
We're done? Aw, Pickles. I want to keep helping the planet. Can't you think of anything else we can do, Uncle Lemo?
I know something you can do.
You do? Who are you?
This is Hal. He's a scientist down at Cape Cuddly Space Center. And one of my best customers, too.
Yes, I am. And in honor of Earth Day, we're going to ask the kids of Higglytown to contribute items for a special Earth capsule we're making.
What's an Earth capsule?
An Earth capsule is kind of like a scrapbook. It's a collection of everyone's favorite things about Earth that will let space travelers in the future know what a special place our planet is.
Space travelers?
Are you gonna launch it into orbit?
Better than that. We're going to put it on a rocket and send it to the moon.
The moon?
Cool. That's awesome!
Hey, I've got a scientific idea. Would you kids each like to find something to put in the Earth capsule?
Yeah!
Well, what you looking for, Twinkle?
A rainbow! I'm gonna put it in the Earth capsule. Rainbows are super pretty, so they'll show how super beautiful our world is.
I hate to be a shoe fly in the pie, but you can't put a rainbow in the capsule.
Why not?
'Cause rainbows are made by light, which means you can never catch them.
Now what am I gonna put in the Earth capsule? Wait a minute, I've got an idea. I'll put in a seashell. That way the space travelers can hear the beautiful sound of the ocean.
Surf's up, don't you know?
A lake is too big to fit in the capsule. A snowman would probably melt, and a river might splash all over everything. I just can't decide what to do.
You know, Wayne, lakes, snow, and rivers are really just all different forms of the same thing, water. Why don't you put a little bit of water in the capsule?
That's a great idea, Fran. And I even have the perfect thing to put it in. My official Jungle Skunk Canteen.
Looks like I'm all washed up.
Got it.
Got what, Yubi?
What is it?
Well, first I thought I'd get a cloud, but they were too high to reach. Then I decided the smell of freshly mowed grass would be perfect, but all the lawns have already been cut. Then I tried to catch the summer breeze, but it kept changing direction.
So, what'd you get?
All of those things. Air.
Good pick, Yubi. You betcha.
Hey, Kip, are you looking for buried treasure to put in the Earth capsule?
Nope. Something even better. Dirt!
Dirt?
Yep. Worms love it, plants love it, and kids like me like to dig in it.
Like I always say, what better to put in an Earth capsule than Earth?
So what are you putting in the capsule, Fran?
I'll give you a hint. It's my favorite treat to eat. And it can also grow into an oak tree.
An acorn!
Bingo bongo, you kids got it. Guess that means we're finally ready for tomorrow's big rocket launch.
Yay!
Here's the stuff for the Earth capsule, Wayne and Twinkle's Uncle Lemo.
Wouldn't want to leave without that now, would we? But let's put it in something a little more sturdy. Let's see. Coffee pot? Nope. Omelet pan? Double nope. Hey, this blue box ought to do the trick. It's just the right size.
Oh, sorry I'm late. The robin's chicks in my tree hatched last night. The Those little newborns are cute as the dickens, but they jabbered all night long. I didn't sleep a blessed wink. Whoa! Almost nodded off there.
Great news! They found the keys to the rocket in the pocket of a spare spacesuit, so everything's go for the launch.
Excellent! So I guess
we should get going too. Come on, everybody.
Cape Cuddly Space Center, here we come! Hey, Fran, wake up! It's time to go to the Space Center.
What? Space Center? Oh, my wiggly whiskers. Wait for me.
Yowzer, doggies, take a look at that rocket.
It's enormous.
Good morning, folks, and welcome to the Cape Cuddly Space Center. Today, you will witness a historic event, the launch of the Higley Space 21 mission to the moon.
Isn't this exciting?
Huh? What? Ooh, you betcha.
And that's the entire history of our proud space program. Which brings us to
today. Jiminy!
In honor of Earth Day, this rocket will carry a capsule containing a collection of favorite things, mementos of Earth, chosen by the wonderful children of Higglytown. Children!
Hey, that's us! Come on! Who's got the Earth capsule stuff? Oops! Got it!
Here it is, Mr. Scientist, sir.
Great. Ooh, this box is heavier than it looks. Ooh, thank you, Kip.
So long, seashell.
Bye-bye, bucket of dirt.
Sayonara, jar of air.
Goodbye, jungle skunk canteen full of water. Toodaloo, fluffy squirrel tail.
Fluffy squirrel tail? Fran!
Hey, Dad. I think Fran's in our Earth capsule.
Your Earth capsule? What's she doing in there? They'll load her onto that rocket and send her to the moon.
We know. What are we gonna do?
Leave it to me, kids. Stop that golf cart!
Stop! Stop!
T-minus 2 minutes and counting. We have 2 minutes to lift off.
It's too fast! We'll never catch it!
What are we gonna do?
Pizza guy!
Greetings, space dudes! What's shaking?
Fran is about to be loaded onto that rocket!
Whoa! They're gonna send Fran to the moon! Huh? They're gonna send Fran to the moon?
Along with the Earth Day capsule, which is going to lift off inside that rocket in 2 minutes.
No worries, space cadets. Be it land, sea, or outer space, Pizza Guy is on the case. Courtesy of the Pizza Tram Express. Yeah, hop on. Now buckle up, and off we go. Garden dude!
Our box full of Earth Day stuff is gone! And so is Fran!
Look! They're loading it all onto that rocket!
No, 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 stop! Stop!
Wait! Wait! No, wait! No, wait! No, wait!
6, 5, 4, 3. All engines are go. We have liftoff.
That nap was refreshing. I feel light as air, don't you know? Oh, heavens to Higglyberries.
Poor Fran. If only there was some way we could tell that rocket to turn around.
You know something, Yubi. There just might be. Come on, everybody, back in the pizza tram.
Where are we going, Dad?
To Mission Control. The scientists there will know what to do.
I hope you're right.
Whee! This sure is fun, eh, kids? Kids? Hey, where the dickens are you, rascals?
Faster, pizza guy, faster! We gotta save a squirrel!
Oh, now I get it. We're playing hide and seek. Okie dokie, ready or not, here I come. Aha, I found ya! Okay, maybe I didn't find ya. But I did find a super-looking shell and a spiffy canteen full of... Oh, water! And feast your peepers on this spank-dandy disco suit.
Coming through!
Huh? What in the...
Higgly!
Now where could those little Higglies be? Look at the size of that moon! And hey, what do you know? Right over there is the Earth. But if that's the Earth, and that's the moon, then I must be on a rocket ship. And if I'm on a rocket ship, then that means...
I'm the first squirrel in space!
Ooh, don't you know? Don't you know?
Ooh,
you betcha! Now, squirrels can jump and sort of fly, but none of them have ever made it quite this high. I can swing on Venus, I can shake on Mars, I can even dance on shooting stars. I can juggle some acorns on the moon, I can jump on Jupiter to any doom. I can do my thing on Saturn's rings, I'm up in the sky without any wings. I'm a funky squirrel in space, don't you know? I'm more funky than a monkey, and certainly way more. With so many things that light up and glow. I'm funky when I'm flying and I'm funky when I land. Even if your planet doesn't have a band, I'll be dancing. I'm still dancing, always dancing. I can never get enough of shaking my stuff.
Oh, I'm a funky squirrel in space, don't you know? It is I.
Fran? What are you doing?
Huh? Who said that?
We did, Fran. We're in the control room at the Space Center.
Oh, goodness me. How embarrassing.
And you're on the rocket ship heading to the moon.
I kind of figured that.
But don't worry, Fran. You'll be back on Earth before you know it.
Actually, Fran's rocket's not coming back. We've programmed it to land on the moon and stay there with the Earth Day capsule.
Stay there?
But it can't stay there. How will Fran get back?
I know. She'll catch a ride on a cow. A moon-jumping cow, that is. Today's the day the Interplanetary Rodeo is coming to town. Coming to the moon. Which means that Cowboy Joe Bob, the most famous alien cowboy in the galaxy, will be there.
Yee-haw! Look at me!
Well, when it comes to lassoing moon-jumping cows, he's the best. So, all Fran has to do is grab hold of alien Cowboy Joe Bob's lasso. And she'll be on Earth faster than you can say, good giblet gravy.
That sure is one high-jumping idea there, Twinkle. But the thing is, alien cowboy Joe Bob isn't attending this year's rodeo. He hung up his spurs and retired to his ranch on Jupiter to raise comets.
Aw, Pickles.
But if that rocket isn't coming back and Frank can't catch a ride on a cow, she doesn't have any way to get home. And if she can't get home, she'll be living on the moon for the rest of her life. What are we gonna do?
Maybe we need the help of someone special.
Someone special? Who could it be?
This job's too big for you and me.
We need some help.
But never fear, oh. It looks like a job for a Higglytown hero.
A Higglytown hero.
I'm a Higglytown hero, brave and true. I help the world with the things I do. So work real hard and you will see that you can be a hero just like me. A hero just like me. Heard your friend is lost in space. Worry not, I'm on the case. I'm an astronaut, you see. Outer space is my territory. Astronauts have lots of fun exploring space, the moon and sun, flying rockets, measuring mist, collecting rocks for scientists.
Can you dance with three-eyed things on planet Saturn's rings?
We'll see what that trip brings.
Can you bounce inside a crater with a lunar alligator?
There's nothing greater. Saturn, moon, or far Pluto. Any place in space, I'll go with my rocket ship and crew. I'll travel to worlds brand new. I'm a Higglytown hero, bold and good. I help my friends just like I should.
So work real hard, that's what we'll do. So we can be a hero, just like you. A hero just like you.
What do you know? We're almost there. Make sure you're all strapped in tight.
Way, kids.
Hey, look! Fran's space capsule!
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's go, let's go, let's go!
Fran!
Greetings, Earthlings!
Well, looks like this space mission is a success.
Yeah!
Thanks for coming to get me, Ms. Astronaut. Would have gotten pretty lonely there on the moon without someone to dance with.
Anytime, Fran. Traveling through space is what I do. But you know, I'm not the only one to thank. As soon as your little friends here realized you were in trouble, they asked the adults for help.
Well, I'll be a blue-nosed moon maid. Guess that makes you kids...
Higglytown heroes!
Hey, kids. Look familiar?
Is that the Earth?
It sure is.
Wow. Looks like people did their part for Earth Day. The Earth looks extra clean.
And so beautiful.
Yep. And it's our home.
You know, kids, visiting the moon was fun. No doubt about it. But there's no place this critter would rather hang her space helmet than planet Earth. What can I say? Earth is the planet for me.
What's the hole for, Fran?
You remember that acorn I put in the Earth capsule? Well, guess what? While it was mixed up with Kip's dirt and Wayne's water, it started to sprout.
Wow!
But since trees can't grow on the moon, I thought I'd bring it back to Earth and plant it right here.
Good idea, Fran. Planting trees is good for the Earth.
Yep, and it's good for yours truly, too. Now that my feathered friends have their own home, I can get a good night's sleep, don't you know?